I have three items that I'm testifying on. My name is Justin Huey. I am a third grade teacher from the burned down King Kamehameha III Elementary in Lahaina. And I am testifying on my concerns of the governor's emergency proclamation that happened 3 weeks prior to the fire and how it suspended seven state statutes, of which exonerated everything that you guys are in charge of, covers county organization administration, chapter 46, collective bargaining was rescinded, school impact fees, collective bargaining was rescinded. And to my knowledge, this was the first emergency proclamation in the country that didn't have a preceding incident. Normally it's like a hurricane, boom, we got an emergency proclamation. But this was just, from my knowledge, was just to streamline development on Maui, and it is allocated all decision-making power to one person, the housing officer of the governor, Nani Medeiros, who's unelected, who can trump every single thing that you do and everything that you say and every item that we cover without any input from the community, without any public discourse, without sunshine law. Before I go to my, tomorrow, I love what you said, Lahaina's not for sale, please include us. But I don't see that happening. And I was able to meet with Nani Medeiros. I graciously invited her into my home in order to speak with teachers from the burned down King Kamehameha III Elementary and their own homes. And they're moving forward with they're meeting with developers, private landowners, and not a lot of community unless you know how to maneuver correctly. So before I go to my next item, I would just like to ask each council member to let me know, are you in favor of this emergency proclamation that takes away sunshine law, collective bargaining, all your power in decision making? I would like it if you did me a kindness. And before I go on to the next item that I want to testify on, who's in favor of that? Because I have serious concerns.
Mr. Huey, we don't have discussions at this point. We're just taking testimony. But I'm sure each member will be happy to respond to you on their own.
All right. So can we end this item and go to the next item?
Sure. Yes.
I was asked to start a teacher work group with HSTA on housing, and I was able to get people that talked. We were able to talk to Nani Medeiros, and they really need. I would love to see you pass a resolution on foreclosures, mortgage evictions, subsidized rentals. It's a lot of different things happening right now. Like, there's one teacher that lives on this side, but had three other jobs besides teaching in Lahaina and has a $4,000 mortgage. So his house didn't burn down, but he's going to lose his house if something isn't done quickly. A different teacher who's had their house burned down moved over here and is trying to buy a house over here, but other investors are trumping her. And I just can't say enough about my concern over the fact that we have streamlined development without any community input, without sunshine law, without public announcements, without meeting notices. I just can't say enough. Everything that you do can be trumped by one person who's unelected and has no community input. And for me, I just think that, I wouldn't know why. She also said that she met with four council members and they were in complete agreement with the emergency proclamation. So that means there's four council members here, allegedly, that she stated are in agreement with getting rid of sunshine law, collective bargaining, school impact fees, and chapter 46. And it's like, my question is, why did you run if you're not going to step up to the plate when we need you the most? And This needs to go. This needs to go right now. This is disaster capitalism of $5 billion are coming to Maui and sticky fingers are here to take it all and develop everything without any input. Lahaina needs to decide what happens in Lahaina. But it's not just there. It's everywhere. And anything you do on this island can be trumped by one person. And more people need to be standing up and saying that this is not how government works. This is not how we teach our children how government works. And this cannot move forward.